10 minutes earlier. It's a corpse in a wedding dress. Documents, phone, money, or jewelry on it.
Has the preliminary examination revealed anything important?
We estimate the time of death between 11 p.m. and 1 a.m. The victim has a temple wound and a bruise and graze on the left cheekbone. Nothing on her. It looks like a robbery gone wrong. We're trying to identify her now.
I might already know. Natalie Lurie. She's a supermodel. I've seen her name all over the internet. Yeah, she recently blurted out something controversial about a fashion designer.
A model? Sean, see if you can find anything on Lurie in the database. We'll examine the crime scene.
Consider it done.
Hello, detectives. Is this a murder weapon? I'm not sure it matches the wounds.
Well, there could have been a fight in the park. Our victim could be collateral damage.
I'll check it. It could be a piece of evidence.
Detectives, how's the investigation going? Have you confirmed the victim's identity? Yeah, it's, Natalie Lurie. She's from Kansas. She has a clean record, nothing more than a couple parking fines.
We also found out she was renting an apartment above the Irish pub near our station. Chili McChubb is the pub owner and Lurie's landlord.
All right, head over there.
Thank you.
Mr. McChug, do you know Natalie Lorry?
Yes. She and Ray Church are renting an apartment for me. Ray's my cousin's son. He's an extreme cyclist, but more of a slacker than anything.
And, when did you see them last?
Maybe yesterday morning. I don't keep track. But I'm hoping this means they're out and about somewhere. Every time I see them, I regret renting to them.
Do you have Natalie's and Ray's phone numbers?
Sure, feel free to write them down. Why? What happened?
Natalie Lorry was murdered in a park close to your pub last night. Where did you get those cuts on your hands?
That's horrible. But, my hands, right? They're fine. I just cut them on a loose nail when I was carrying some crates.
Ray called Natalie 5 times between 10:30 and 11 p.m. Now, he called someone else too, but they didn't pick up until calling back 15 minutes later.
Natalie's records seem usual. She called Ray, the agency, and her parents. Nothing after 7:30 p.m.
Contact the distance, honey. Mr. McChug, did you forget to tell us something? Yeah, you're grabbing Ray Church by the chest in this photo.
The time and date here suggests this photo was taken shortly before Natalie's death. It doesn't look like a friendly conversation. You said you hadn't seen either of them since that morning.
I'm overloaded with work here. So what if I forgot some little detail? Happens to everyone.
Now, why were you fighting with Ray Church?
It wasn't a big deal. He owes me half a year's worth of rent. So we had a little skirmish. I reminded Ray about his debt. He said some rude things, so I gave him a bit of a shake-up. In a loving kind of way.
If he wasn't paying his rent, why didn't you evict him?
Ray is family. Him paying rent was more of a formality. It's just, my patience has its limits too, you know.
Thank you, Mr. McChug. Please let us know if Ray shows up.
Murder weapon was likely made of wood, with a hematoma on the left cheekbone being caused by a blow just before or during death. No signs of a struggle. Time of death, between 11:30 and midnight.
Is there any evidence to suggest the body was moved?
Not yet. These types of injuries usually aren't accompanied by heavy bleeding. The broken bottle you sent me has no relation to the victim. It had already been there for several days.
Thanks, Will. We've also received information from the agency. Natalie's contract was terminated for undisclosed reasons. Her last photo shoot was just before the murder. She was supposed to be at a presentation soon after.
The party took place not far from the studio. It explains why she was wearing such a luxurious dress in the park at night.
Detectives, you're curious why I'm here. A horrible tragedy befell me. My good friend Natalie Lorry was murdered.
Good friend? Sure, whatever you say, Miss Fox. Now please, if you have anything on Natalie or her boyfriend Ray, please tell us. We don't mind working together with you again.
I promise this will benefit us all. So, Natalie was a talented girl with great prospects. But she grew vain. She only had to apologize to the fashion guru to end the scandal, but she was too full of herself. I mean, a scandal can make you big. But Natalie wasn't the brightest girl out there. That's how she got blacklisted by all the top agencies. She was in a lot of debt. Her boyfriend was a penniless loser. Because of his arrogance, he missed the chance to sign a high-paying contract with Monster's Bike.
When did you last see Natalie?
Yesterday evening, I came to pick her up from the studio at 10 p.m. so we could walk to the party together. Instead, she chose to stay with that strange Douglas guy. He's just another failure in the world of fashion. She said he was going to make special photos for her portfolio. Maybe she wanted to apply for something more serious. She even said that everything would work out for her soon. Ugh, I gotta go. Here's my email address. Be sure to send me some hot news.
Thank you.